3 up here. Center.
Welcome to the ThePapare viewers, wherever you're watching today. We're at the Royal Complex ground in the heart of sunny Colombo. I'm Paul Toyer and I'll be taking you through the introductions for this 2016 Milo President's Trophy semi-final match between Isipathana College and St. Peter's College. And I can tell you that it's a glorious, glorious sunny day here in Colombo. It's positively balmy at 31 degrees. It's 72% humidity and there's not a cloud in the sky. I've got to say that the track looks hard and dry, and it'll suit both teams if they're going to play hard running rugby. But there's a couple of questions that will be asked of both teams here today, especially Isipathana. They'll be asked how will having a week's rest affect their edge that they've had going through the whole season unbeaten. And St. Peter's will be they'll be asked the question, how do you beat this team? So those are the questions that will be poised today as both teams take the centre stage here. And as I said earlier, as far as the weather conditions are concerned, and you can see on your pictures there and on screen, it's a beautiful sunny day. But with more of those questions, we can hand over to Shanika down on the ground. Are you there, Shanika?
Good afternoon and welcome to the Milo President's Trophy semi-finals coverage live from the Royal College Sports Complex here. It's the big semi-final, another big one coming up tomorrow, but the first semi-final is Isipathana, the favourites, taking on St. Peter's. The league match between these two teams ended very, very controversially as well, because we had St. Peter's with 14 men down for most of that game. But to find out what they're thinking about this rematch, I have Sandesh Jayavikrama, the St. Peter's captain, with me to chat about his team's chances for the first game. Sandesh, me match ek gana mokadda hitanne league match 14 men utte ekka ogollo paraduna habai me match ekka 15 men thiyagena ma vinadi 80 gahanata balanna
o athasem ape waridirin thamai apita e match ekka magarune eginda api me match e waridi attarla hondin kreeda ganna balapothu
podi injuries wage thiyena
sandesh positional changes wage kut thiyena sandesh ada gahanne center eke diat fernando full back gahala thiyenne me dala thiyenne e positional changes gana mokadda hitenne team ekak strong de eka hinda
o athasem api hariyata position dan andru wenna thiyena eginda api e widiyata
Sandesh, captain hattier teekshana eshanu utteka centers wala gahanne Isipathana centers hongak strong ogolla mokadda preparation ne kala thiyenne defense wala
aniwaryen ganda balabothu
Sandesh, good luck, all the best. And that was Sandesh Jayavikrama. He's not saying much, but he knows that all his talking will have to be done on the field. But the favourites for this trophy and the favourites for today's game, also given their unbeaten run in the league championship, is Isipathana. Kushan Indunil, their captain, unbeaten in the league, joins me this time. Kushan, may match ek confidently?
Ethem ulaku me confidence ethi na mukada den mon kiyo wage natichche de thamai api ganna yanne mukada e natichche de ganna me match ulaku focus ekin me match api hondara sellan karala mukada St. Peter's kenne ఉంద టీమ్ ఎక లీగ్ ఎక్కడ వెనమ టోర్నమెంట్ ఉంది నకౌట్ ఎక్కడ వెనమ టోర్నమెంట్ హెమదేగం లాస్ట్ లెవెల్ ఇన్ లోక అభియోగ ఎత్తిరు
లీగ్ మ్యాచ్ ఎక్కే సన్ పీటర్స్ అయిల పలవిని వినాడి పహేమ ట్రై ఎక స్కోర్ కర కుషాన్ మదక ఎతి ఏ స్టార్ట్ ఎక గంద ఏగొల్లంట దెండ హదన్ నెద్ద మే సరే
ఎత్తరమ నే ముగద ఏగో ఏకే మ్యాచ్ ఎక ముగద ముగద కౌరి స్కోర్ కర ఎదిగల ముని కేన బే ఎండ్ ఎక కాడత్ కేన మోర్
Kushan, what are the changes here on the main side? Forward pack at Mahitan, make a change at the end?
A change when a year is about again hard thing on a school layer. I think a change again to a hepatic medical caragana is within technical me and take on.
Visit Natu put the Kamaru with the forward starter?
Visit Gano, Sri Lanka.
Right, so that's the change that was expected to happen is not happening. So, Kushan, how are you thinking about this match? You are going to win this easily, or are you looking forward to the finals before that? Kushan, thank you very much. All the best.
Okay, thank you.
And that was Kushan, isn't it? Joining us, the Isipathana captain as well, looking good for this semi-final lineup, and both captains very confident, but you can see they're under a little bit of pressure, both of them. Isipathana also looking like they will be the ones to beat on this particular day. It's a nice hot day here at the Royal College Sports Complex, and both teams nice and warmed up. You can expect a cracking game of rugby because St. Peter's absolutely have nothing to lose. They can throw everything at this game because they know it might be the last match that they play all season. So look for the broken field runners of St. Peter's, Shaneshan and the Athanandu, to cause some problems, but Isipathana looking confident. Over to you, Paul.
Thanks, Janneke. A couple of excellent interviews, and we could actually feel the anticipation and the pressure that the both teams were feeling there. And as the ground's starting to fill up and the crowd's starting to filter in, you can start to feel that there's a little bit of anticipation here. And as the teams continue to go through their warm-ups. I've got to say that St. Peter's are looking very crisp in their warm-up, and they're running very sharply as they're going through their moves, and you can see in the middle, you can see the Isipathana team, they're in a circle and they're tight. As you can, there's a crowd shot and it's starting to fill up, and people are starting to wait here for the 2016 Milo President's Trophy semi-final between Isipathana and St. Peter's. They're the supporters from St. Peter's, the St. Peterites, and they'll be waiting with bated breath because they know that this is their chance for their team to throw everything on the line, and now what have they got to lose here? Isipathana are pulling themselves in tight and doing what they've done all season so far. They're working as a team. They've worked so hard for each other during this season, and they've had a lot of success. Then we see the dignitaries and the VIPs up in the VIP area, and they're all waiting, and everyone's waiting here for the commencement. And we've still got 25 minutes here before it all kicks off. So I'd imagine the players will start going back into the dressing rooms, going back in together, start thinking about their jobs, start thinking about what they need to do when they kick off. The coaches will have one or two more words with them, then they'll hand over to the captains. The captains will have their last say, and then the teams will come out, and then it'll be all on. And it's a do or die game. It's a knockout game, so we'll know that both teams will be giving everything. There's nothing left for the loser. The winner goes on and plays in the final next week, and that'll be between one of these two teams and also one of the teams that play again and the other and the semi-final tomorrow between St. Thomas's and Royal College. That's at this ground here tomorrow afternoon, and that you can see that on ThePapare.com as well. I'll be here for that match, and I'm sure you will be too. So Isipathana have gone back into the sheds. They're going to do a little bit of private motivation. St. Peter's is still out here. They're warming up. They're going through a few contact drills. They'll be making sure their bodies are ready to go for the contact. Their minds are ready. Emotionally, they have to make sure that they're grounded, that they're ready for contact. And in their minds, they need to know that they've done everything they can to prepare for this match. As now they're linking up, they walk past their supporters, they get another one last cheer. They're heading back into the changing rooms. The anticipation, as I said, is starting to build. There's people coming into the grounds. Stands are starting to fill up slowly. It is such a lovely day here in Colombo. I can imagine some people will be at the beach, but true rugby supporters will be here watching their teams as they go head-to-head for the 2016 Milo President's Trophy semi-final here at the Royal Complex ground. And here we see St. Peter's go back in, and we have a little look at the crowd, and they're all just waiting there patiently. Those ones there, where you can see there in the shade, but there's There's other ones over here on the other side of the field who are avoiding the sun as well. And if you're in the sun today, you'll know it's a hot day. So we have to make sure that the players are all hydrated before they go out. Whenever coaches have an opportunity to get water and rehydrate players on the field, they'll be trying to do that as well. So there'll be people running water and instructions onto the ground the whole game to make sure that the players don't get cramp or start to seize up in these hot conditions. There won't be any Milo or anything like that going out. Obviously, there will be lots of hydrolite and the like going out to make sure that people are all hydrated and continue to play at their best. So that they're the conditions here today, and as I'm joined back here at the moment with Shanika, and Shanika, I could see down there at ground level that the players are keyed up for the game. There was a lot of intensity in the conversations, and so the players are ready to go.
Isipathana are quietly confident, as has been their form all season so far. But St. Peter's, for me, look really motivated, Paul. They're going to be playing as a team with absolutely nothing to lose in this particular match. For some of them, it could be the last time they turn out for St. Peter's as well. I think they're well aware of that. And they're a good forward pack. They've gotten better as the season went on, and I think they'll take a lot of heart from that victory over Trinity in the last match that they played in the league. Isipathana are going to take some beating, but if they're going to do it, Isipathana might be the St. Peter's team might be the ones to do it on the day.
And you'll see in the first couple of minutes that there'll be a lot of emotion on show, and there'll be a lot of adrenaline flowing through their body, and they'll just be coming out here and trying to hit Isipathana as hard as they can. But the thing is with Isipathana this year, we've seen that they play for a full 80 minutes. We saw that when they played Royal in the second to last game of the league. They didn't get over Royal until the last 5 minutes. They went for the full 80 minutes against St. Thomas's in the last game of the league. They had a week off last week, so I'd imagine they'll go for another 80 minutes this week.
Yeah, I think fitness-wise, they will be in a good place because they had a bye. They didn't actually have to play a quarterfinal because DS Serenayake pulled out, whereas St. Peter's came through a fairly tough encounter the last time as well. So, but that might work both ways, Paul, because Isipathana have been off for a week. Maybe their intensity will take a little bit of time to kick in. St. Peter's might be completely ready to go as they just get off the boat. So you never really know how these things pay off, whether the rest has been good or whether the rest has not been good. That's what we're going to have to wait and see as things go on. We've got the Isipathana team card coming up for you. This is the Champion League team. They're the runners-up in the Sevens tournament as well, and they've been unbeaten in the league. Not many changes today. They were going to change Lahiru Viswajit, but he's opted to play today despite his injury at number 4. He joins Sudhira Gayanath in the second row. Madhushan Mabitikama and Ekanai have been excellent up front. Veerathunga Gunaratna and Veerasinghe has been an outstanding player at number 8. Harith Bandara, Randy Silva, Chamod Fernando, the elusive left-winger, Kushan Indunil and Sumudhu Rankotke, the rock around which this Isipathana team is built, Ranidu Padmasankar and Gayan Vikramaratne, who has been kicking brilliantly in the last couple of games. Paul, I don't see too many changes there. There's a lot of rhythm among those teams, so coach Nilufa Ibrahim has chosen to go with the team that he trusts. So there was a little bit of an injury cloud over their big second row, Viswajit, but they've chosen to go with him because his St. Peter's pack is not the smallest one either.
That's right. They'll need his bulk there. There's the St. Peter's College team come up now as well.
Yeah, the big man, Rahul Delpachitra and Ravi Nyapa, the senior player, played well against Trinity. Udukumbura, Nanya Kara, Pereira, Shane Gurusingha, Sajid Seram and Angelo Mendes is coming in place of the injured Prema Vardhana. Avish Kahin Pal, a lot will rest on his combination with Stefan Sivaraj today. Can they allow Teekshana Dasanayake in the number 12 jersey some space? Nonis is on the left wing. Sandesh Jayavikrama, the captain, is in the centers as well. Shehan Ratnayake and Diath Fernando, he's the man who is a really good broken field runner. So let's see whether he can cause some damage from the back. But Isipathana, rest assured, will not be kicking into his hands. We've got the replacements coming up at the moment as well. Umesh Jayamana, Manabarana, Nilamudin, Anjula Vimadava, Fernando Hettiarachi, Ruberu Kulasekara and Azmi for Isipathana. And we have Vitanayaka Biangwila, he's a senior man. Zaruk Mendis, Bhagya Dilshan, Bimel Fernando, Madhusankar and Kemin Vimaladasa making up the numbers for St. Peter's College on the replacements bench. And you can trust me, they will all be called upon on this hot day today, Paul.
That's right. You saw it in the internationals in June that, yeah, it's actually all about a 23-man squad, and they'll be using the 23-man squad here. The players that, when they're called on, they'll be coming in and trying to make an impact. And the players that start will all be looking to say, okay, I can play 60 minutes, you can go on and you can play the last 20 minutes. And that's where you could use the whole 23 as a squad.
Absolutely. And joining us in the commentary box, Paul and myself, we're very honoured to have with us two former Sri Lanka players, two gentlemen who captained the CRNFC club as well and played with distinction for their schools back in the day. Shamli Nawaz for Isipathana captained in 1998, and as many as 10 years later, Ishan Noor turned out for St. Peter's as well. And good to have you all in the commentary box. Shamli, the favourites Isipathana for the moment, but do you think that this game is going to be a little tougher than the previous ones?
Say anything about these kind of games, and these are knockout tournaments, so everybody can have their own day, and the ground looks really well and a good day for rugby, fast running rugby. So I think Isipathana, after a week's break, I think they'll have to go full guns out to beat St. Peter's.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a tough one. We'll be back and ask Ishan's thoughts in just a moment. But at the minute right now, we have Haritha Pereira, who's going to be taking us through the early formalities before this game kicks off. We'll be back in just a bit in the commentary box.
So it's a big occasion for the players themselves. It will show us their best, and some strong rugby is on the cards if the two teams play to their full potential, and we certainly hope that that will be the situation. We welcome you. Thank you very much for your patronage of schools rugby, and certainly for this match, we are extremely happy that you are here in your large numbers. The match commissioner today, in fact, two of them would be Zena Ranjit and KSP Karunaratne, the coach of match officials, that's the CMO, Mr. Shamrat Fernando. Today's referee is Mr. Dinka Piris. He'll be assisted from the touch lines by Pradeep Fernando and Aruna Shanta, while Madhava Vijayasiri, SMS Samarakon, and Harshan Vijayvira will be also on the officials list for the game. Ladies and gentlemen, here they come, the two teams. Brilliant occasion for us to enjoy. We invite the match officials to please line up. To cordially invite distinguished invitees to please walk out to the middle to be introduced to the two teams and of course the match officials. We would welcome on behalf of Nestle Milo, Mr. Sajiva Vikramasinghe, the manager activations, Mr. Muhammad Ali, the senior brand manager of Milo, on behalf of Nestle, the worthy sponsors. We would also welcome the Vice Principal of Isipathana College, Mr. B.H. Priyankara, and the Sports Coordinator of St. Peter's College, Reverend Tilina Patum. On behalf of the Sri Lanka Schools Rugby Football Association, we welcome Mr. B. Abheratna, the Honorary President, Mr. Sarat Chandra De Silva, the Honorary Senior Vice President, Mr. Denzil Darling, the Honorary General Secretary, together with Mr. Nirodh Vijayarama, the Honorary Treasurer. Ladies and gentlemen, the distinguished invitees would meet Isipathana College, Captain Roshan Nidunil, Head Coach Nilufar Ibrahim, Master in Charge Sumedha Chanaka, the unbeaten league champions of this year, won this tournament for the first time in the second year in 1996. They have won altogether on six occasions. They were runners-up last year and champions the year before. They are looking for their third final appearance with a win on this occasion. The match officials controlling the game today would be Dinka Peris. He'll be assisted by Pradeep Fernando and Aruna Shanta on the touch lines, together with Madhav Vijayasiri, SMS Samarakon, and Harshana Vijayveera. The match commissioners, of course, N.A. Ranjit and K.S.P. Kanwaratna, and the CMO Shamrock Fernando. St. Peter's, the inaugural winners of this championship in 1995. Sandesh Jayavikrama is the captain, coach Colin Danish, and the master in charge Sunil Apanso. They won this tournament 3 years in a row from 2006 to 2008. Apart from 1995's first victory, joint champions in 2010. The teams met in the league. Isipathana went on to win 36 points to 21. But the two teams with that very rich culture, tradition, and great expectations on the part of their big following will be very happy to see a top game. We thank the distinguished invitees for joining us on our occasion to be introduced to the two teams and the match officials. Being a leading brand in the sports world right around the globe, and indeed in Sri Lanka, Nestle Milo celebrating 150 years. We'll be looking forward to always innovating and giving you a novel experience, and using the high technology aspects available on the sports field today, there is a great opportunity for all of you to enjoy a wonderful segment just before the start of our important aspect. Ladies and gentlemen, please await a novelty from Milo. ThePapare is the official match ball from the quarterfinals onwards. Well done, Dinka. You may not kick it. And A-Goal International, the sole distributors for ThePapare in Sri Lanka, have provided the match balls. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great occasion for all of us to be here. And if you are a old boy or a present boy or a well-wisher of the two schools, this is the time. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. This is the school anthem for St. Peter's College.
Lend a heart and lend a hand, and lift the flag on high. Let its glorious colors give a greeting to the sky. Golden glow. garden, fragrant flowers. Who shall dare to point a finger when such joys are ours? Work enduring, fellowing, fill our happy hearts. Hills all curing, health ensuring, in St. Peter's mind. And our flag is floating proudly, let us sing his praises loudly. Lend a heart and lend a hand, and lift the flag on high. Let its glorious colors give a greeting to the sky. Golden gleam and silver sheen, and blue that crowns the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, the school anthem for Isipathana College. Bhoomi Sudhi, Vasara Dedas Dasa, Visidevana, Milo, Janadipati Kusalana, Pilimalun Pitudakime, Vasa Duvisan Pahala Pasal, Rugby Papandu Tarangavali, Mulma, Avasan Purovate, Tarangia, Prabala Kandam, the Kak, Kulamisi Patanasa, Bamalapitia, Shant, the Peter Kandam, Matra, then Arambaviri Matanimitai, Tarangi, Vishesh Avasta. Saji Vilasa Dakagani Matahakiavak Tivna, Dialogue TV Hara, Saji Bavarne, Apikanda and Dekatama Superpatana, Sri Lanka Jatika, Pasal Ravi Pavandu Sangame Saha, Nestle Milo Vetin, Krida Loli over Samata, Itama Tun Tarangak, Jakabalagani Ravasta Udakarmin, Upper Tarangi Barakarna, Tiraka, Tinka Pirista.
For the break, we were just about to ask Ishan, what do you think about this St. Peter's side, Ishan? Do you think that they've got what it takes to pose a challenge in this game?
It is in fact St. Peter's. I mean, previous few games they have not been having lacking of consistencies, but they had some bad games against Science. But here onwards, I think they had pretty good games against St. Anthony's and Trinity. So they are pretty much up forward to face the challenge against Isipathana.
Yes, it's an interesting kickoff which was competed for by Isipathana, and St. Peter's couldn't manage to handle it in the air. And Isipathana seemed to have retained the ball in this first couple of exchanges. And Harith Bandara will look to settle things down, going to his forwards on the blind side.
Ekanayaka is held up strongly by Rahul Delpachitra first of all, and then manages to go to ground, and Bandara still has it now. Kusan Idunil, that first receiver. We'll watch for him to do a bit of that today. Again, Bandara with a longish ball out. The kick is put in by Gayan Vikramaratne, and Diaz Fernando spots the space. Adisa Veerasinghe is the man who goes back. And it looked like a bit of a knock forward there. Let's see whether the referee says it went forward. Yes, he did. And Chamoth Fernando makes the first mistake, the first telling mistake in this game. And St. Peter's have been rewarded with a scrum for that flying defense that they put in on those couple of phases. So, Paul, an intense start to the game already.
Yeah, I thought the first mistake there was that Isipathana had numbers on the side. They had 4-on-3 overlap, and if they'd run straight, drawn past, they might have had a man over, and instead they kicked the ball away, and that opened up the opportunity for the kick back.
Gayan Vikramaratne with that kick there that gave Diaz Fernando a little bit of a sniff of space. Avish Kahim Palla to put the ball into this scrum. And how important is the scrummaging going to be, gentlemen? Shamli, you've been a forwards coach as well. What will you be telling this smaller Isipathana pack against this big unit of St. Peter's?
Yes, Shanaka, actually, Isipathana, if they want to dominate a game, the forwards definitely have to do a lot of work on the set plays. Last week with St. Thomas's, the forwards delivered. I think they will deliver today itself.
Himpella with the first feed, and Angelo Mendes controls this at the back. It's gone down, so the referee will blow it back up. St. Peter's traditionally strong in the forwards, Ishan. What would you advise the St. Peter's pack to do in the face of this attacking Isipathana team?
We should, especially the Petrides, they need to keep the ball with the forwards as much as possible and then send it out. I think, like you correctly said, seems like the Isipathana forwards are a bit small, but they are very much mobile, whereas compared to St. Peter's, where they have some big forwards and big ball carriers as well.
Let's see if we can get this one completed this time around. Angelo Mendes again, he's forced to go on the open side, so Harit Bandara tackles him pretty easily. Himpella. Straight through the middle. And Mahapiti Gama straight over the top there. And I'm surprised that that wasn't a penalty coming for St. Peter's. But it doesn't matter now because Chamoth Fernando has got some space. Puts the quick in. Diaz Fernando is covering it well. And it might beat everyone into touch. It does. So an untidy bit of work from St. Peter's at the back of the scrum ball. And Isipathana all over it.
It did look a little bit untidy. It looked like the number 8 went the wrong way, so he was tackled by the number 9, the halfback. But it looked like there wasn't any clear release by the Isipathana player on the tackled St. Peter's man. And there they got to have the turnover. They saw the space on the outside and they moved it.
Yes, the tackle area is going to be a real bone of contention in these next couple of games. It's not the easiest thing to referee in the world, and lots of controversy already. Pereira goes up and wins that line out, the first one for St. Peter's. And here's Ravi Niapa coming off the back. He needs some support though. Well brought down there by Gayanath. Here's Angelo Mendes standing off the back. A little number 8. He's a burly chap, so he can go quite low. Sandesh Shavikram at first receiver. Now they've got some numbers. Speak Shaneshan leaving the ball behind. Was Nonis who had come in.
I think Shanaka, the first breakdown.
Diaz Fernando. Sorry, Jamli, you were saying?
The best, first scrums, two scrums were, I think, evenly contested. I think there will be a lot of evenly contested scrums today.
I did notice, Shanaka, there that there was a 5-on-2 overlap for St. Peter's, but not one player committed the inside man and made his hips turn. And therefore, the two men could just drift across.
That's overthrown, but cleaned up nicely in the line-out. Avish Kahim Palla in an almighty tussle with Gunaratna. Gunaratna wins that one, the flank forward on the scrum half. You'd expect him to win it. But going wide, a nice decoy run, but Sumudhu Rankotge now had some space to put Padma Sankar away. Randy Silva puts a little bit of a kick in. Himpella has dropped back. It might have just a little bit too much on it. And Aviska Himpella might have just stuck his foot over the deadline and collected that ball if he had some awareness there, but it might have proved a little bit of a risk. But the penalty has already been given, so it wouldn't have mattered anyway. Lefty ThePapare is pointing to the post.
Yes, Anna, it looked like the number eight for St. Peter's just got up a little bit too quickly and got caught offside. And that's why that kick option was put in, because the referee was playing advantage.
Ishan, the last game against between these two teams, rather, St. Peter's started well, they scored early, and then they had that red card to Premavag, the number eight, and played most of that game with 14 men. Do you think that there'll be a little bit of smarting from that, a little bit of revenge that they might want to seek?
Pretty much indeed. I think you saw some early on, we saw some big tackles from the Peterites. But unfortunately, in the press is losing the ball, especially in attacking play. So this is going to be a tough game, and it's going to be a bit of a revenge playing on as well.
Kyan Vikramaratne with the first kick of the evening. Hot conditions. It's quite still here at the moment. It's a nice breeze across the grounds just before kickoff. And at ground level, it won't affect this kick too much. Vikramaratne has been striking it well in the recent past, but not that one. Just going a little bit to the left, so the first miss of the day. Won't matter though, because the Isipathana are a team that prides themselves on their ability to score tries. Jai Vikrama, the skipper, number 15 on his back. He started the season at fullback, but now has moved to the centre. Supata Tekshanesha, now Vikramaratne. He steps straight through the middle, brought down by Sivaraj. The knock forward was spotted by the referee, who's allowing Pereira to carry on with the advantage. And now Sandesh Javikram, a nice long flat ball to Yapa. Yapa needed to give the offload. Now they've still got an opportunity, even though they squandered that. Oh dear, Ravin Yapa, the senior man. Isani had numbers to burn on his outside and chose to go into the contact.
Probably was playing advantage and he didn't realize that he had already ran through a bit for too far. He should have passed it because the numbers are out, and he being a big man, I don't think he has the pace to go all maybe about 60 meters.
Well, that was all caused by the compressed defense there by Isipathana. There was the one pass there that missed maybe six players, and that put that space on the outside. So they'll need to work on their spacing there at our ruck time to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Yes, it was an excellent pass, a nice flat pass right across the face of the defense by Sandesh Jayavikrama there. Seen Aaron Smith do that beautifully for the All Blacks. Just take completely five, six defenders out of the play. The knock forward was backwards, says the referee. He's absolutely right. And cleaning that up was the Isipathana defense test. A long ball over the top by Kusan Indunil. Padma Sankar is well taken there by Nonis. Bandara. Here's the big prop, Ekanayaka. Bandara again looking for the short runners, but opting to go long. Rankotke to Veerasinghe to Fernando, and the cover tackle is good.
You see some early on big tackles coming from both teams, especially Petra dominating. Even over there, the cover tackle was superb to put the man out of the field.
It was good defense there by St. Peter's, because Chamoth can be really dangerous, and they're using Vagisa Veerasinghe on the flank as well. So he's got a lot of pace. He's going to be roaming the grounds. Has had an absolutely outstanding season so far. St. Peter's, once again, an untidy line-out ball, and Heen Pella has to go back. Mendes. Strong run by Angelo Mendes, but now they've got to clear their line, St. Peter's. Not try anything heroic from here. Absolutely no depth, so Avish Kahin Palla will have to go for it himself, and it goes all the way back and bounces into touch. Oh dear, that was a bit of a shocker there. And you have to say Avish Kahin Palla didn't get any support or any protection from his forwards.
And Shanaka, I feel like both teams, they are playing patches, because Isipathana, they'll work to the corner, and the next move they'll go to a line out, and they'll lose position. I think going forward in this game, both teams, if they manage to have position in hand for more, I think they might have a good game on their side.
Watch for Isipathana's maul from here. They've been practicing the driving maul, and Adisha Veerathunga is the man who wins this. But good body position in defense from St. Peter's first up. But the drive is on now. The leg drive is good from Isipathana. Still pumping away as a unit. Referee says once. And now they've got to come away with it. Vagisha Veerasinghe is the man who comes off the back. And the ball is there for Bandara if he chooses to swing it quickly. But St. Peter's have managed to set their defense again. They look like they're going to keep it close. Ekanayaka. Oh, that was Madhushan actually, who bundled it forward. Trying to attack the fringes. Randy Silva to Kushan Indunil. He's well brought down by three Pete Wright players who are waiting for him. And that was good defense from St. Peter's. Indunil isolated, so they had to go in after that ball.
They did, but there was space out here, out wide, because the Peterites were all on the wrong side. There was maybe six or seven on the other side marking two men, and there was space, so they just needed to move the ball a little bit wider, and they would have, might have been able to put
it
on the try line.
If we had done another pick and go in the opposite side, because there was space that area.
Zaire Vikrama, another not a very good kick. And Vikramaratne has an easy time, can afford for it to bounce as well. And Randy Silva now spots a bit of space. He's smashed into the ground by a big tackle from Ratnayake. Or Pereira it was, the number five. And now they've got some space. Avishkaheen Palla trying to snipe around the corner. Now he's got help from his forwards. But Isipathana managed to rip the ball, which comes back volleyball style on the Peter's side. And now they've got men over again if they choose to use it. Thikshanesan, he needs the ball now. Ravi Niyapa chooses to give it. Good choice there. Thikshanesan manages to pick it up off his boots. And now quick ball from Ravi Niyapa once again. This time he needed to put his head down and just go forward. And it's an untidy ball. Randy Silva hacks it forward and Sandesh Jayavikrama clears. Kushan Indunil. And now Gayan Vikramaratne looks for the long ball out to Chamod Fernando. Fernando with a little bit of space. Excellent defense on him. Steven Sivaraj somehow manages to grab this ball out of nowhere. And the first try once again in this Patana Peters encounter going to St. Peters. And absolutely against the run of play intercept there. Both teams throwing the ball around like a hot potato. Nobody wanted to keep a hold of it. That's what Chamli was saying a little earlier about the teams not getting any continuity. And it was an opportunistic try, but it'll score you 5 points nevertheless.
That's right. There was no there's no protection at the back of the rucks and mauls, and so the ball's just being spilled out and kicked in the back, and there's no no actual rhythm or pace being created by the protection that needs to come when the ball's coming back from the rucks. But so the ball went backwards and forwards, and then is it going to try to split it to the other side after recovering? And
I think Isipathana paid the penalty for playing in their territory. I think they should have gone straight away territory towards the opposition 50, and I think they paid the penalty for that.
Yes, St. Peter's with a terrible kick from their 22 to get out of trouble. And that one bounced, and still they managed to get the counter-attack opportunity going. And they had a lot of opportunities, but Ratnayake was the one who managed to convert one of them. And Isipathana find themselves 5 points or 7 points to nil after Stephen put the kick over. So, Ishan, again, very much of the same deja vu-sided type of thing from the league game?
Of course, yes, indeed. But there had been no face play that I haven't seen much. There had been some broken play over there. What happened was, pretty much good defense once again by Peters. They managed to good well, but again, once again, a really bad kick put, but didn't collect it well.
Isipathana now through Gayanath. Good work to win the ball back from Isipathana. And now here's Padmasankar, manages to step in on the inside and beat one man. Pereira makes an important tackle on him. Randy Silva. Peters up really quickly. And good defense once again by Nanya Kara. The second rows have been doing quite a bit of work in defense. And they've managed to turn it over now. And straight up the middle goes Mendes. I'm not sure that was the right call. Rahul Delpachitra was in front, but I think they managed to get through. Didn't really cause too much of a difference. But referee Dinkapir is making the call nevertheless.
It was a great play by the big man, number four for St. Peter's. He got his body over the ball and got a good strong base. Legs were wide and he got over the ball and managed to smuggle that ball back. But we can see St. Peter's, their line speed at defence is really quick. So they're trying to cut them off at Isipathana off at the 13 and make them turn back inside, and it's working at the moment.
Yes, this pair of Jayavikrama and Teekshan Eshan up against Rankotke and Kushan Idunil, so it will be a good contest. First Isipathana scrum goes down and the referee will blow it up, and that's one of the seven rule changes that have come in World Rugby from today, that if the scrum goes down and there's no effect to the play, you can carry on. So that's always good. You won't find things like this happening too much.
And also, I think this come wheeling as well, where it will be to the footing side and it's not going to be for the opposition.
Yes, and that's the other rule change as well, which will affect the scrum, where if the scrum wheels through 90 degrees, the team that threw the ball in will get it back instead of it going to the opposition. So that will prevent defensive teams from doing the crab walk or just running around and trying to wheel the scrum illegally.
Oh, that's apply for today's game, Shanaka?
A good play once again from Avish Kahinpalla. Managed to really put pressure on Vagisa Veerasinghe here. And St. Peter's needs some quick ball. Good defense by Randy Silva on the big forward. And now they've got numbers to burn. Straight through the middle. Excellent work, but needed some support shot. Isipathana had committed in defense and they needed somebody marking the middle, but the referee says there was a knock forward. So St. Peter's making all the play here. And Sandesh Jayavikrama is going to have to ask referee Fernando, or Dinkapiris rather, to not give a yellow card to Avish Kahinpalla, who's arguing his case very vigorously here.
Once again, are those rules applied for this game, or is it are those new rules are going to be applied? No,
I'm not sure they're applied in this tournament, but it will be applied from the next bunch of international matches that will be played. So I think the Sri Lanka Rugby Football Union will need to adopt them formally here and write them into the tournament committee tournament rules as well. So Isipathana are pretty lucky to get let off their ball. Once again, they had a yawning gap on the outside of defence, and St. Peter's just didn't want to go through it.
Yeah, that's right. Well, there's space on the outside, but a gap opened up to the number 10, and he went straight through it, and he was just looking for a little bit more support, and they turned the ball over quickly. I'm not sure what the penalty was for, but there was space down that far side again, and if they'd gone that way, I'm sure they would have scored another try. But the interesting thing about this is that St. Peter's now have belief, and that's an important thing. If they believe that they can win, that's an important thing for them.
Absolutely, and Isipathana have taken a while to settle down, but that's completely crooked. And Devin Gunaratna will have to give the ball back. So they haven't made too many mistakes, Isipathana, in the lineouts. That was one of the few, but the first one also was overthrown from the hooker Mapitagama. So just needs to get to terms with the breeze and the jumpers and the sun and the shadows and all sorts of things.
I think Shanaka, the Isipathana team, has to now settle down. I think they are trying to score immediately, but having position will win this game. I think a message should come from the bench. Settle down, because they are just sending it wide and losing in process.
Yes, they're trying to go wide. And just to remind you in this breakdown that the Basketball Championship 2016, for the first time in history, the Papare.com sponsors the Under-19 School Basketball Tournament, which is titled the Papare Basketball Championship, from the 8th to the 17th of this month. You can follow the live webcast from the quarterfinals onwards. St. Peter's to put in on a scrum that presents a nice blind side, and Avish Kahinpalla chooses to take it, goes on his own. Needs some mates now, which he finally gets. And now St. Peter's managing to keep it tight with their forwards. Kahinpalla gives it to Sivaraj. Sivaraj throws the dummy. Jayavikrama has to support his fly half. and now it's still available. Teekshana Yashan now with a barge up the middle. He hasn't seen much good ball. And a penalty coming for the tackler not rolling away. And Isipathana will pay the price for that as Sandesh Jayavikrama points to the post. So it could have been a 3-point mistake.
Well, it could have been not rolling away, or it could have been not releasing. Either one would have applied there. But you can see St. Peter's are trying to play an up-tempo game, and they're getting to the rucks and mauls, quickly turning the ball over and trying to attack before Isipathana can reset their defence.
Yes, the clean-out is good, isn't it, Shambli? And that's what Isipathana are finding hard to combat. The Peter's clean-out has been pretty decent.
Yeah, I think they are using their body weight. I think bigger boys cleaning out the small men, Isipathanian. But Isipathana has to secure their ball, I think. If you need more numbers, you have to, because otherwise there will be turnovers throughout the game.
Stephen, he's got a rip right down the middle of his trousers, so it looks like he's wearing an apron. Won't stop him from knocking the kick over, though. And St. Peter's lead, 10 points to nil, a shock lead in the semi-final. A lot of neutrals would have expected Isipathana to be the favourites, but as we see Sivaraj Stephen changing his shorts in the middle of the field. Ladies, if you're watching this match, look away. He's got it back on now, so it's safe. But 10 points to nil. Shamli, Isipathana will need to put a score together before half-time.
Yes, Chanaka, I think Isipathana has to get the act together.
Great collection there from the Peters forward. And the same thing they tried the last kickoff, but this time they got it right. Avishkaheen Pella with the box kick. It's a better one this time. Still not a great one, though. Vikramaratne coming forward, takes it beautifully. He's only a little man, Dan Vikramaratne, but got up nicely for that one. And now some space for Kushan Indunil. Sumudhu Rantukge. Good tackle on him by Nonis. Nonis has been making some important tackles on out wide. Marpita Gama. The pass looked like it was forward, and now they have space once again. Udukumbura. Heen Palla. Peaks and Eshan. Inside on the switch to Ratnayaka, the try scorer. Numbers once again for Ravin Yapa if he chooses to use them close range. Heen Palla. And again, they've got numbers to Burns and Peters outside. Sandesh Jayavikrama has to give this, and he does. Rankotge gets bounced off. And that's on the ground. It looked like a good turnover, but it wasn't, because the player was off his feet. That was Kushan Indunil, and he knew exactly what he was doing. And the referee calling immediately for reinforcements, because Padmasankar is down. It looked like he might have taken a bit of a head knock. The skipper looked very concerned about the fate of his winger.
I think Isipathana is not actually making advantage of sun shining right onto the opposition player's face. I think over there, even the kickoff was towards the shade, whereas they could have probably changed strategy towards kicking towards the middle or even towards his right. So Peterite might take it a bit difficult up in the high ball, whereas they are not taking that as an advantage.
Absolutely right, Ishan. Because St. Peter's will be looking into the sun at least for the next 10 or 15 minutes. And when the turnaround happens, Isipathana will face the setting sun as well. Padmasankar has been stretched off. Well, not stretched off. He's walked off by himself, which is a good piece of news for Isipathana supporters. He's got a nosebleed by the looks of things. But very positive play.
That's right. That was a very positive play. It looks like he might have just had his nose reshaped there. As all players who play rugby know that can happen. But now we have St. Peter's, they've got another opportunity to stretch the lead a little bit further, and their belief will grow again.
Well, 13 points to nil is not a deficit that St. Peter's have faced at any point during this season, so it'll be a test of character for them. How do they come back as well if this one goes over? And it's a great kick. It's an excellent kick from Sivaraj. He's lost a little bit of weight from when this season started, so he's actually able to contribute much better than he was contributing earlier on in the season.
He's had a couple of really insightful runs. He's had one, and then he tried to go again, and and the defense were waiting for him. So that means the next time he has the ball, he can look to run straight and then distribute, and there'll be players that'll stay on him and that'll create space on the outside.
So poker game at fly half, isn't it? Trying to bluff your opponents. And
I suppose Isipathana has had has a pretty good line, but I haven't seen them utilizing them, whereas the ball has been stopped in either second center and hardly gone to the wing.
Well, it looks like we might be seeing a replacement if Padmasankar can't continue. It's a bit of a loss for Isipathana if the right winger is not able to go on. It might be a blood injury, so we'll find out in a moment. Beautifully taken there by Devin Gunaratna. Brilliantly done in the air. In fact, it was Adisha Veerathunga. But despite his good work, it looks like the line out may go to St. Peter's. No, it doesn't. It's back with Isipathana. Vikas Srimadhav is already on the park. That was the change that we were talking about before kickoff. That looks like Viswajit has gone off, the big number four. Kushan Indunil, here's Rankot K for the first time. We're seeing a bit of running from Vagisha Veerasinghe. Great clean out once again. Outstanding work from Pereira in the second row, who has really made a nuisance of himself at breakdown time. Veerasinghe dances behind his own man. And here's Vikramaratna again. That pass is behind Randy Silva. Udukumura chases back. And wrong footed was Ratnayaka on the wing. Diaz Fernando now. Swarming all over him was Randy Silva. Real contest for the ball, which Isipathana have won now. Adisha Veerathunga drifts across, tried to get Chamoth Fernando coming in on the switch, but didn't work. Lack of communication there, but it looks like Isipathana have the penalty coming. And now they've got a whole lot of numbers. Opting to put the kick in for Nonis to chase back, but he'll get there easily. And the penalty will come back. Randy Silva could have really thrown it wide, taken a bit of a risk.
Well, the numbers, there was 9-on-2 there out wide, and all they had to do was put it through their hands, and they would have had a huge overlap and probably scored in the corner. But he was playing under advantage, so he just looked up and saw a space out there, and someone needs to tell him. One of the players on the outside of him needs to say, let's just put it through the hands.
Well, I think that happened, Paul, because you could see Randy Silva getting a bit of a pat on the head there from one of the senior men, and he saw Vagisha Veerasinghe telling me in no uncertain terms, mate, we had men over on the outside, what the hell were you doing there?
I feel Shanaka, Isipathanians are very in a hurry to score points. They are just throwing the ball, they are playing seven style. They are not structured in the play. So I think they have to quickly turn into structured play, otherwise it's going to be too late for Isipathana.
Yes, and this might be one of the effects that we were talking about before kickoff, Paul, of the fact that they haven't had a quarterfinal game. So they've been off for a couple of weeks, whereas St. Peter's have played a couple of games in the lead up, so that might take a little bit of time for them to settle. So let's see where they are in the second half. Veerathunga, they drive the mall forward once again, and the collapse has already come from St. Peter's. Still going, Isipathana. This is how they put the first sword into St. Thomas's as well. Still going, and it's over. And who else but Vagisha Veerasinghe, the man at the back of that mall, just powering his way over from close range. And that'll settle the nerves down, Shamli.
I think at last the structure worked for Isipathana. They kept the ball with them, they pushed them, and the first call was in, but I think they break off, and Vagisha scored a beautiful try.
Yes, that's, they needed to come back into the game. They couldn't allow it to drift away any further. They are a champion side, and as we've said before, how they come back into this game will stand them in good stead when they go into the next round, if they manage to make it through this match. So it's a huge pressure test for them.
That's right, but we talk about having to play with patience and hold on to the ball, but really they haven't been allowed to do that because the counter-ruck from St. Peter's has been so vicious and ineffective. And that's from playing a game last week, and they know that they're battle-hardened and they really want to rip into it. So every time they have an opportunity to have contact, they're trying to leg drive and push the Isipathana players away, and that's where Isipathana just aren't being able to hold on to their pattern play.
Isipathana's calling from line-out drive is rarely heard of, but seems like they are doing it really well. Henry would have put some sense to them to do the line-out drive, and they are doing it really well.
Well, that kick is away as well, so Gayan Vikramaratna unfortunately hasn't been having the best day with his boot in the first couple of kicks. He's your teammate, Ishan. You played a lot of rugby with him. Did you imagine that he'd be such a good coach?
He was a good player. And I remember seeing him taking notes, especially when the foreign coaches come. So I saw there was a vision for him probably to be a good coach. And he did pretty well with Wesley and now here with Isipathana.
Yes, he really has developed quite a bit. So good to see that the foreign coach's expertise is being used well by Sri Lankan coaches as well. Sandesh Jayavikrama kicks off, and that's taken by Devin Gunaratna. Harit Bandara, again, the defensive line is up very quickly from St. Peter's. It's obviously something they've talked about. Randy Silva, they're running in their own 22. Gayan Vikramaratna doesn't need the boot when he can do that. Slipping and sliding under tackles. Makes his way up to the 50-meter line. Udukumbara was offside, but the referee says play on. There was no ruck there. Harit Bandara, Randy Silva now. Not a great pass from him, and Vagisa Veerasinghe goes back to clean it up. And straight to the middle goes Veerasinghe. His acceleration is outstanding. Powering through tackles. Padmasankar is protecting that ball on the edge of legality. Ekanayaka and Madhushan combine the two front rowers. And it's still available for Isipathana. This is the continuity that Shamli was asking for. It's a long ball. A beautiful miracle ball almost from Kushan. Even if Ramkut K will run it in. You just need to give them a sniff. And like piranhas, they're all over you, Paul. You cannot keep this Isipathana team out.
That's right, we talked about the patience, and they didn't need any patience. They're just going to go and try and score every opportunity they have. And inside their 22, they took it, and you're seeing here the final moments where Rangotke got it down and just next to the post. But that was all about the number 8 here on the closest to us, where he stayed on his feet and drove through. And if he'd found an extra player, he had support of maybe 3 or 4 players. If he'd found one of those players, they would have scored earlier. But after 2 more phases, that went over next to the posts.
And Shanaka, I think this is the first time that Isipathana had the ball in all the play till they scored. Otherwise, they would have lost the ball in mid because the counter-rucking was so good from St. Peter's. But this time, they managed to ruck it well and get it going.
Yes, 2 defensive lapses from St. Peter's. One allowing Gayan Vikramaratna to run 30 meters up to the 50-meter mark, and then allowing the isolated Vagisa Veerasinghe to just power through a couple of tackles on the near side. And suddenly, from being a 13-point game, a couple of missed tackles, and it's a 1-point game, Ishan. Half-time couldn't come soon enough.
Isipathana got the momentum by scoring that tie with the forwards, and they kept on building up on that. Whereas Peter Wright has been in the back foot, they need to build up some faces. And very important to get the discipline right. Whenever they have come to our half, there have been some penalties. And over here as well, that they have scored. So we need to get the discipline right and get the faces going on.
This is where Sandesh Jayavikrama will be important for his team. Whether he can marshal them into not giving up at this point, because St. Peter's body language is already flagged. They seem to be a little tired because they've been really working hard to get the line speed up to make sure they counter-up. And this is where all that work will begin to tell. Lovely dummy once again from Vikramaratna. Puts the kick in. And all the speedsters are after it. But it looks like Diaz Fernando is the fastest man on the pitch. And manages to put the ball into touch and save his team some blushes. But St. Peter's seem to be inviting Gayan Vikramaratna through their ranks.
Yeah, that the 12-13 channel's not being covered up because that St. Peter's are looking at the outside and they think that's where they're going to go to, and there's just a little dummy and a shimmy and he's through the hole, and that's a second time. So let's see if the next time he tries to do that, they can cover up.
Yes, he's only a little man, but got real power in his hips the way he manages to swerve them through tackles, and did the right thing by putting the kick in there just to play the territorial game before halftime in this Milo President's Trophy semi-final between Isipathana and St. Peter's. Beautiful win in the line-out by Veeratunga again. And Isipathana powered their way through. That maul has come down, but the referee says it's fine. That might not be fine. Still walking it. It's 20 meters, and referee says it's a penalty to St. Peter's. But he went down and came back up again, and he's marched it forward 10 meters again. And again, that was not 10 by Harit Bandara. Referee allowing that to go on. Not sure whether that was the right move by Avis Kahin Pala to take it quickly. They just needed to clear their lines, St. Peter's. Just get some relief from the pressure that Isipathana have been putting them under. Thumped backwards into the hands of Padma Sankara, and now they've got space. Veera Vikramaratna, the long ball out to Kushan Indunil. Rankot Gerada, who puts in the goose step and the big fend. It's available once again for Randy Silva. Randy Silva to Ekanayaka. The two front rowers working together. Silva, Rankotge, straight into Nonis, who's made three good tackles already on him. And here's Mapitagama, Ekanayaka, manages to control the ball only just. Bandara now with the numbers outside. Indunil straightens it inside to Vaki Savira Singh. But it's just gone forward. The pass from Indunil to Agisavira Singer just went forward, but again, you could see that he understood that the defense was drifting and went inside for such an intelligent bit of play from the skipper.
That's right, the defense was drifting and it's been continuing to drift. And what's happening is they're placing their 4-5 in the middle and after rocks, and they're having to do all the work, and they obviously don't have the pace to cover the backs. But what I'm more impressed about is once they get through the gap, and sort of break the first line of defence, all the players flood the area, and there's so much support for Isipathana, and that's why they're making so many yards once they make one break.
Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, ThePapare.com, brings you Sri Lanka's premier club competition, the Dialogue Champions League, as 18 clubs battle for supremacy. Live action every Saturday and Sunday, 3:15 p.m. onwards. Well, it might be a weekend of upsets, gentlemen, so let's not call this game before, just because the momentum is with Isipathana at the moment. We saw Sam Querrey two sets up against Novak Djokovic in the Wimbledon third round, I think it is, and Wales beat Belgium yesterday in the Euro quarterfinals. So who knows where this game might go. Ishan, what will the halftime talk be for Colin Dennis and this Peter's team?
Mainly to keep the ball with St. Peter's team, and also to counter the line-out drive of Isipathana. It has been very strong, and whenever they have done the drive, I think they have gained about a few meters.
Avis Kahin Pala is looking to take these things quickly, Ishan, and the rest of his team sometimes not keeping up. He needs to actually bring the rest of his team into the game. It might be time to play it a little too quickly.
True enough, the previous quick tap he took actually to gain advantage of 10 meters, but we saw a lot of the players were actually coming in during the quick tap. So we didn't unfortunately get the advantage over there.
Another good tackle by Nonis Vikramaratna, trying to dance out of another tackle. Tishan Eshan grabs him this time around. But another good counter up from St. Peter's. They've conceded the knock-on, but they've put Patana under pressure. Padma Sankar going in, rocking, playing the ball. Mapitagama now, Ekanayaka rather. Manages to get the ball beautifully done there. And Gayanath, or Vimadhava this time. Again, an excellent counter-up by St. Peter's, but Vikramaratna still manages to come away with it. He's having the game of his life with the ball in hand, not so much with the boot. but really causing a bit of trouble. One of those Jason Robinson type fullbacks, Paul.
Yeah, he's got great balance, great speed, and he can spot a gap, and he just reads the pitch that's in front of him. He can see which way players are drifting and where the gaps are going to open up, and accelerate straight through the middle. But there we see that St. Peter's have got such great intensity and tenacity in the breakdown that they're flooding through the little counter-working opportunities, and it's causing Isipathana a lot of problems.
Yeah, I think you're right, because St. Peter's, they were breaking all the rucks and they were trying to spoil the ruck. They were putting their legs in and spoiling. I think Isipathana has to realize this, and they have sealed their rucks. It will be very important going forward in this game.
Serum has come on at number 8, and it looks like Angelo Mendes takes a seat. And again, another free kick. The referee is going to have to start talking to Isipathana if he's going to be giving free kicks like this. That's a long ball by Sivaraj. It's not a good one, though. The line was a little too flat. But the referee says play on, and Diaz Fernando puts the kick in. He's brought down, but referee says play on. And a good clearance in the end by Isipathana. But he was brought down illegally, so the referee will take it forward to where the ball bounced. And St. Peter's will have a chance to get more points on the board before halftime if they manage to execute properly here. Don't forget they were leading 13 points to nil a few moments ago. Isipathana with two quick tries, bringing it back to a one-point deficit. And the big forwards choose to take on their opponents in close combat this time, but it's half time, unfortunately, for St. Peter's. Don't manage to get any points from that particular foray. So it has been a very entertaining half of rugby, gentlemen. Paul, it's 12 points to 13. Isipathana have done well. They've had the momentum in the last 10 minutes. Will this halftime break change all that?
Well, the coaches will be having a word to them about what they need to think about both teams. And I think St. Peter's just need to keep on going with your defensive style.
They need to throw up their holes at 13 channels. But as far as breakdowns are concerned, they need to keep putting that pressure on. As far as this together are concerned, I think they need to just put an extra man into those rucks and mauls.
Just make sure that they have another man in there, making sure the ball doesn't come out. Once the ball's at the back of the ruck, then they can take their time about resetting and then going for another attack and then another phase play. But I've got to say that St. Peter's have had a great half. They started really well. They had a lot of belief. They got 13 points out in front, and they can come out again, and they can do that again in the next half.
Wazi, you've been in this position before, where you've got to go into a half-time huddle. 13 points to 12 is absolutely nothing in it. What do you say to this champion side?
I am of course sure that Nirupa is telling the boys stick to the game plan, because I think today, after the games that I have seen today, I think Isipathana is a little bit deviating from their original plans, and they are playing a little bit of seven style rugby. So I think Nirupa will tell them to keep the ball with them and retain position, and I think what the rough situation will be a very important topic in the half time. And I think the forwards, Henry will have to tell them that the set pieces they will have to win, because Isipathana has been giving free kicks out of about 2-3 free kicks in scrum, so they can't do that in the second half.
See how things go when we are back with the second half action from this Milo President's Trophy semi-final. It's the first semi-final here live on DTV and also on ThePapare.com, brought to you by Milo, of course, who have been sponsoring this tournament for nearly 20 years now, I think. And it has been an outstanding tournament, has produced some fantastic upsets as well. And will we see the underdogs go through in this one? They're leading by a point at halftime, but we've got plenty more rugby coming up in this game. So stay tuned on ThePapare.com and Dialogue TV. We'll be back in just a bit.
I start each day with a dream to win. Training, working hard, rain. How strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life. කොහේ ගියත් කොතැන හිටියත් ශ්‍රී ලංකා පිළේ එංගලන්ත සංචාරයේ උණුසුම් අවස්ථා ඔබේ මොබයිල් එකෙන් සජීවීව Dialogue My TV වෙතින්ම පමණයි. ඩේටා කාස්තුවක් නොමැතිව දවසටම රුපියල් 333ක් වැනි සුළු මුදලකට ඇති තරම් නරඹන්න. ස්පෝර්ට්ස් ටයිප් කර 82 82 SMS කරන්න. Dialogue වෙතින් My TV අනාගතය ආදායි.
ළමයෝ දැන් ඩේටා වලට ඔච්චර ලෝභ වෙන්න ඕන නැහැ. ඔන්න ඩයලොග් හෝම් බ්‍රෝඩ්බෑන්ඩ් එකේ ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
එහෙනම් ඩබල් ගෙවන්නත් වෙයි.
නෑ, තීන ඩේටා වගේ ඩබල් ලැබෙනව පරණ ගානටම නොමිලේ. ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ අංකකේ සා වේගවත්ම ඉන්ටර්නෙට් සම්බන්ධතාවයෙන් දැන් රෑට ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
ඩේටා ඩබල්.
ඩයලොග් අනාගතය ආදායි.
With a dream. Through connectivity, technology, and talent, that dream can become a reality. Asiata, with you every step you take.
This is the story of a nation on the move, competing globally through a fiber optic network, delivering solutions instantly with superfast 4G, redefining entertainment with 3G HSPA Plus, making every day more efficient with Wi-Fi. Bringing a world of knowledge to your home with fixed 4G. Get connected to Sri Lanka's fastest network. Dialogue, the number one choice of the people. Dialogue, the future today.
Sawadikap, can you give me data sim?
Massage?
No, data sim.
Massage, very good.
No, data sim.
You are Sri Lanka? Why you no use Dialogue data roaming? Unlimited data, $5 a day.
Unlimited data for just $5 a day?
Yeah. Unlimited same massage you want?
Me?
Unlimited data roaming for just $5 a day with Dialogue roaming. Clearly the best way to roam.
One for one is all I want. One for one is all I need.
Here, what's all this one for one talk?
The one for one plan from Dialogue. Get 1 MB free for every 1 minute of talk time. Per second charging and a flat rate to any network.
Dialogue, one for one prepaid plan. Dialogue, the future today.
Here, how are you going to stay in touch abroad?
Dialogue roaming. They give the best rates.
Only if you pick the preferred network. Otherwise...
Just get Dialogue roaming. It's the one and only best rate on any overseas network guaranteed.
One guaranteed best rate on any network? Woohoo!
Hassle-free roaming with the best rates in over 200 countries. With Dialogue roaming, clearly the best way to roam.
Introducing the Ultra 99 postpaid package from Dialogue. Say everything you want to say with the ultra benefits of extra talk time, extra SMS and extra data at a monthly rental of just 99 rupees only. Dialogue, the future today.
Here we are, can I get a data sim? Meh. I say, old chap, where might a fellow find a data sim card? Kiannako.
You're from Sri Lanka, right?
How did you know?
Why don't you use Dialogue data roaming? Unlimited data for $5 a day.
Unlimited data for $5 a day?
Data unlimited, my patience isn't.
Unlimited data roaming for just $5 a day with Dialogue roaming. Clearly the best way to roam.
I start each day with a dream. a dream to win. Training, working hard, rain. How strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life.
කොහේ ගියත් කොතැන හිටියත් ශ්‍රී ලංකා පිළේ එංගලන්ත සංචාරයේ උණුසුම් අවස්ථා ඔබේ මොබයිල් එකෙන් සජීවීව Dialog My TV වෙතින්ම පමණයි. ඩේටා ගාස්තුවක් නොමැතිව දවසටම රුපියල් 333ක් වැනි සුළු මුදලකට ඇති තරම් නරඹන්න. ස්පෝර්ට්ස් ටයිප් කර 8282ට SMS කරන්න. Dialog within My TV අනාගතය ආදායි.
ළමයෝ දැන් ඩේටා වලට ඔච්චර ලෝභ වෙන්න ඕන නැහැ. ඔන්න ඩයලොග් හෝම් බ්‍රෝඩ්බෑන්ඩ් එකේ ඩේටා ඩබල්.
Very good afternoon and welcome back to this semi-final game between Isipathana and St. Peter's in the Milo President's Trophy. Live from the Royal College grounds, a nice hot day with the shadows lengthening across this Royal College ground. And just to let you know that Isipathana are trailing the underdogs by 13 points to 12. So just 1 point in it, Isipathana had rocketed into a 13 points to nil lead. And St. Peter's had rocketed into a 13 points to nil lead. And then we had Isipathana coming back towards the 10 minutes before half time. And that turned out to be the period in which they managed to go into a 12 points on the board and go into a 1 point deficit. Joining me in the commentary box, Paul Toya, Shamli Navas, and Ishan Noor. And it looks like the referee is just having a bit of a chat between the two captains, Sandesh Jayavikrama and Kushan Indano. Two nice big backs, two good prospects for Sri Lanka as well. Wonder what that's about, gentlemen. We didn't see anything untoward happen.
Maybe we might just be welcoming them back like two boxers welcome them back in for the last round. Just a little chat. There was a nice little moment where they sort of touched hands and said, okay, let's get on with it. So they're back there ready to go and just waiting for the Milo ball. Maybe the drone's going to bring it in. Or is that a pigeon bringing the ball in? No, it's someone kicked it in.
Well, no drones for the second half. I think the match ball was presented to us with much pomp and pageantry here. Milo trying to take the game and the entertainment surrounding the game to the next level, of course. They've been sponsoring this tournament proudly for many, many years. I think Shamli, you would have played in the last couple of years that it was sponsored by Milo in 96.
Yes, Shanaka, the days we were playing also, Milo was sponsoring schools rugby from the when I was 13 years old to 20 years.
Yes, I think my first tournament in 89 was also Milo sponsored, so they've been around for a long time. But the penalty, the knock forward is coming. And a little bit of untidy play there. That's been letting them down.
St. Peter's means business, I think, in this half too, because they've straight away gone in and pressured Isipathana.
Well, that's what we saw in the last, the beginning of the first half as well, where you can still hear the players can still hear the coaches in their ears. And the coach would have been saying, okay, now we have 40 minutes to push on in the season. If we don't do it now, we're not going to have another opportunity. So we're on music from the coach's stalling out in their ears. They're going to put pressure on, and now they have another opportunity here to attack.
So he impounded to speed, and pressure coming from the Isipathana scrum, but it's well dealt with by St. Peter's, and it was Serum off the back there, managing to tie the ball. Gayanath goes in for the turnover, but Ravin Yapa manages to collect the one that bounces through Rahal Delpachitra's legs. Haven't seen Delpachitra with ball in hand too much. St. Peter's opting to keep it close, so you can see that the coaches would have told them just to draw in this defense. Sivaraj, Sandesh Jayavikrama runs straight into Kushan Idunali's opposite number. And now the ball is free, and Tishan Eshan trying to hold off Sumudhu Rankoke, who makes an excellent tackle on him. Drags him sideways. And Chamod Fernando does brilliantly, but it looked like he did so on the floor. Uh, and lots of play just inches from the touchline, but looked like Isipathana were lucky to get that turnover without being called for a penalty there.
Yeah, that's right. I didn't see any clear release, but the referee must have. But they smuggled the ball back, and it's an initiative half fullback saw a little gap, and he thought he might be able to sneak down the sideline and get away. But that gap closed pretty quickly.
Nanakara tries to compete in the lineout. And again, it's available for St. Peter's. Nice inside switch to Ravinyapa. He keeps his legs pumping, but really needs some support now. Good quick ball for Hinpalla. Sivaraj to Delpachitra. Manages to fend off the tackle of Indunil. Haven't seen that happen to him all season, but Isipathana managed to put their boot to it. And now the race is on. Ronkoke chasing it back, but winning the battle was Ratnayak on this side. He scored the try for St. Peter's early on in the game, and he showed a good pair of heels to get back and prevent Sumudu Rankotke from profiting from that hack through. So a good break from Rahul Delpachitra inside the attacking 22 ends up 60 meters down the field.
Yeah, that was an untidy play there at the breakdown, but once he'd gotten through the gap, if he'd passed the ball, it had four-man overlap on the outside of him, and really tidy, as I said, tidy play at the breakdown. The ball came out on the boot, and then St. Peter's were lucky to get away with that.
Yes, it's been the story of St. Peter's afternoon so far. They've broken the defensive line so many times, but not been able to actually finish off those moves. Well taken there by Isipathana. They've not engaged.
Excellent offside!
And it looks like it's going to be a scrum for accidental offside.
Pretty smart move by Peter. It's not engaging over there. I think they read it very well. They thought they should use this because it's pretty difficult to hold on to their line of drive.
Yes, it was obviously something that has been discussed at halftime to try and nullify this driving maul that led to the first try for Isipathana. And almost a second.
And Isipathana quickly transferred the ball, otherwise if he had with the jumper, they should have gone forward. Shanaka, the scrums are still not steady. I think the referee has to talk to the teams, because I felt like the both teams are getting a small wheel when the ball is put in. So that is not allowed. It has to be square and straight.
It is very difficult. Life as a front row forward these days, so many things you can and can't do. Got to make sure you exert pressure, but you exert it forward. And the problem is, if the opposition pulls back or one's prop is a lot stronger than the other. That's a good scrum by Isipathana, but coming away nicely was Serum. Manages to break the first tackle of Harit Bandara. And off the feet, says the referee, so St. Peter's a bit of a reprieve.
Yeah, that's right. But it was brilliant work there from the number eight. His scrum was going backwards. He managed to pick the ball up, break the first tackle, and just stay on his feet and keep moving forward. And that gave them the opportunity to have that relieving kick, but they didn't find touch, and now Isipathana spread it wide and go on the other side.
This is where Isipathana are dangerous. Padma Sankar tries to power through the gap, but it's a good tackle made by St. Peter's. And now Randy Silva.
It was a terrible mistake by the captain, especially kicking the ball in. And this is the second time actually happened in the game.
Referee has not played the advantage there. To the offside, so St. Peter's are lucky to have this ball where they do. Hinpalla, Yapa, Sandesh Jayavikrama with a good spend. He's got a man outside him, he's got to give it surely. But he goes himself and scores. Sandesh Jayavikrama.
He came back, I guess, with his kick going in. I think he came back with a strong run over there. really good run, good send off, and he went all the way.
Well, I thought he was going to pass it at any point here. He was looking inside when he had a man yelling, or maybe the man wasn't yelling. Díaz Fernando looked like he had his mouth firmly shut. But Díaz Fernando could have scored that try easily, but Sandesh Jayavikrama didn't need him. A strong run by the skipper, playing in the center position today.
And number 10.
Because it came out of nothing, Paul.
That's right. Okay. Well, they turned the ball over. They did have numbers, but what I liked is that they're starting to run a little bit straighter than they were earlier, and it's starting to stop the drift defence coming across and covering them up and running them out of space. But he just put into fifth gear and then put the afterburners on and just went ghosted through that gap, and he was away.
I think Shanaka St. Peters is really lucky because referee missed a huge offside when Isipathana was having the ball. I think that gave pressure to turn over. Why then it turns out to be a try now.
I even thought he raised his hand there to signal the advantage, but it wasn't so. And Sivaraj's kick is good. It's very good. It's a 7-pointer, so it's 20 points to 12 at the moment. St. Peters scored first in the first half, and they scored first in the second half as well. Eddie Jones feels that the team that scores first in the second half puts themselves in the driving seat to win the game in close matches. So let's see whether his words are correct.
Sivaraj has got his shape and kicking boots back in place, I suppose.
He has kicked very well today. And now Guru Singha. It's a good kick, but well covered by Vagisa Veerasinghe at number 8 again. Here's Dayan Vikramaratne. Shapes to kick, but gives it instead to Padma Sankar. And now this gap opens up, but uncharacteristic mistake from Sumudhu Rankotge. We've not had him make many mistakes this whole season. He's made a couple already today.
Yeah, the advantage, I think, 3 against 1. But he lost focus, I guess, for a split second.
It's beautiful to see, though, when you see Isipathana run the ball like that. You see them run straight lines, and they just drawn past. And it's what rugby's all about, really, just moving the ball out into space and drawing the next defender out and moving the ball again. And they've just gotten it past the edge, and Rankotge was away there. He had another man on the outside of him as well. He took off the ball.
Yes, I think Kushani Dunal is probably the best at that this season. Straightening the line, making sure he creates opportunities for those outside him. Good strum again from Isipathana, but St. Peter's managed to clear it. Deekshaneshan comes in on the switch with Sivaraj. Good defense on him by Veerasinghe, who rolls away just in time. Pereira. That's a good turnover by Randy Silva, who's not done a lot since then, but the ball bouncing everywhere, but Vikramaratne does really well to clean that up. And now they've got some numbers. Chamod Fernando still going, pumping the legs. Important tackle made there as well, once again by Serum. And now Isipathana will need to bring in that structure that Shamli has been talking about for the last hour or so. Randy Silva, it's not a good pass. Vikramaratne again. Silva with the delayed pass, and that ball could have cost him another 7 points. Deekshaneshan just not able to collect it. But that was a slow, slow pass. You'll watch it here from this angle. Not this one, the one coming up. Vikramaratne gets hammered there. It's a good tackle by Sivaraj. And that's the pass that nearly got picked off by Deekshaneshan. And Randy Silva, Paul, you were saying he hasn't had the best game. It might be time for a replacement to come in at 10.
Well, I actually think they should move the fullback into 10 and give him a little bit more ball, but it looks like someone might have come on who's first receiver. But that was really served up on a plate, wasn't it? That was try time written all over it, but he was unlucky to just knock that ball on.
Looks like the replacement has been made. It looks like Rubero coming in. I'll tell you who it is in a moment.
Captain!
Captain, I am not satisfied with trans.
It is Rubero who's come in at fly half, so Milfa Ibrahim thinking exactly the same as us up here in the box. A replacement immediately, so let's see whether that adds some impetus to Isipathana backline having a bad day, and it can happen to anyone. Randy Silva, brother of Rehan Silva, who plays currently with the CRN FC club.
Fine.
Played at fullback for his team at Isipathana. Ragishas Veerasinghe upended in a tackle, not held though, and now they've got the ball back through Adisha Veerathunga. And here's Rubero straight through the gap. Already the replacement making a bit of a difference. Harit Bandara. Here's Rankotke. And a lovely ball to Vikramaratna, who may have just knocked that one forward on the ground, but the referee says no. Chamod Fernando still going, still dancing, still trying to evade tackles. Surely there needs to be a release there because he's on the floor. Bandara manages to bring this one out of the ruck, and Kushan Indunil might have just overcooked this a little bit. And that could have been a dangerous, dangerous collision. Nothing intentional there, but might have been a little an injury on that side. So we watch it here. Kushan Indunil puts the little dink over the top. Veerasinghe goes after it. And just Padmasankar and his flank are colliding on that far touch side. I hope that's nothing serious.
Surprising that they are not going for the 3-point, or rather kicking to touch. I think they are confident about their line-out drive, and they want the 7 points on board. Isipathana is trailing by 8 points, which means they need a try and probably another penalty as well.
Well, it looks like the line-out drive is what they will be hoping to do. Let's see what St. Peter's tactic is this time. We saw they held off, but sometimes in this red zone, so close to the goal line, that's a dangerous tactic, isn't it, Paul?
Yeah, they look like they've already played that card anyway, so they'll have to come up with something else. But they're not going to.
And Vishwajit does really well there. Gayanath rather holds the ball with him. And if the ball carrier takes it forward, it's not a problem. Isipathana really close to the line now. Couple of pick and goes here. Good tackle again by Ravin Yapa. Isipathana almost over the line. The ball is just short, but here they come out to the back, and Padmasankar drops this one behind him. But the referee has said that there was an offside.
This is what you were talking about early on as well. Discipline is very important, especially close to when you are defending your territory.
Going around the blind side, almost over there. Here's the numbers. Isipathana doubling up nicely. They can see the line. Here's Mapitigama. They've opted to go short, and Subudu Rankotke straightens the line again. Kusani Dunil, strong as ever. And it's a straw. The captain saying, I'm going to do this myself, lads, if the eight of you can't finish it up. But you can see that the fly half coming in has really injected that go forward to them, Paul.
That's right. And you saw the first time he touched the ball, he actually just straightened up. And that just tells the defence that I'm going to take the ball to the line and then distribute the ball. But here we see Isipathana here, really. This is
Kushan Indunil, a good spin and score. I think using his body power.
And great help there by number four as well. But that was all set up by the forwards really driving and taking the ball on and driving it close to the line. And that's what a lot of good teams do. They cut out all the variables, and they just do one or two passes when they're this close to the line, and they just drive over close.
I think vital 2 points for Isipathana. Guyan has been missing a few kicks today. So I think Isipathana will need those points.
This will bring them within 1 point once again. And in the first half, Guyan missed two kicks, two penalties, and a conversion as well. So that's 8 points that he's missed from his boot, which has been very good in the last couple of weeks of the league. Converted all the tries against Royal, most of them against St. Thomas's as well.
Strong drive by the captain. I think he took it to himself and scored a brilliant try, much needed try actually. So Isipathana is now just trailing by just 1 point.
Jai Vikrama kicks it to Vagisa Veerasinghe, who somehow fumbles it, and that's a good chase from St. Peter's.
They didn't have the numbers, other they could have capitalized over there, because the second man also lost control of the ball.
But I don't understand why the Peterite player didn't just go over and pick it up. Ribeiro has very few options, but referee is saying that join the ruck from the side. I think that might be a little harsh. Can see the replay there, we'll see exactly what happened.
Oh, there we see the crowd, and the crowd's actually starting to come into the game as well. There's a lot of noise to our left and right, so the crowd's going to play a part too for sure. But that kickoff and the miss, the fumble by the Isipathana winger there really put his team under pressure, and St. Peter's came through, flooded through, and they were unlucky not to get some sort of advantage out of that.
I think Paul Isipathana has to play tactically now. If they try to do silly things in their half, I think it is going to cost them the game. So I think they have to get territory and get out of their 50, and then the kickoff and things, they have to be very tight, and they cannot have loose ball like that. And St. Peter's almost scored in that kickoff.
Yes, and Kushan Indranil was saying before kickoff that knockout rugby is a whole different ball game altogether. So they understand that, they know that this is St. Peter's side have nothing to lose. They've come through a close game with St. Anthony's. It's an entertaining game, but they still managed to hold their character to win that one. And another costly mistake, Wazi. This has been a problem for Isipathana today. They've not really done well in the set pieces, which is where they did really well against St. Thomas's to win that game. But today they seem to be a little off.
Yes, Chanak, I agree with you, because today the hookers throwing, I think Isipathana, the forwards are taking more pressure on this knockout, I think. They are trying to do too many things, and I think they have just go, because they have a good jumper, and just go straight to him and get the line-out set, because they, in the vital line-outs, they have been pressurized at all times.
And moving sports for just a moment, the audio analysis of the Sri Lanka tour to England is on Cricketry. Catch the update each match day. We are playing a game tomorrow. In fact, we're playing a game today. So that's the final one-day match. You can catch the audio analysis with Roshan Abhisinghe on Cricketry.
There we see the scrum being reset, and it looks like the binds are on our side on the opposite foot side for where the scrum half's putting the ball in. They just weren't quite tight enough in the last scrum.
The tight head side, you mean, Paul? You winger, you? Sivaraj straight through the gap. Ribeiro, oh, the pass just doesn't go to hand. Sandesh Javikram was hairing up, but it looks like that might be a yellow card coming. I don't know for whom. And it is for Sandesh Javikram. Don't know what he did there. Let's try and see whether we can see it on the replay. And that's a huge call. A huge call. Sandesh Javikrama going to the bin for 10 minutes. Manages to hold on to him. And the ball just comes off Javikrama's hand. He kicks it forward. And, well, I think it was for the high tackle. And the neck roll, or going around the neck, that's a tough call, Paul.
It was a tough call. It looked like it was a 50-50 call, 50-50 battle for the ball, and then he just stuck his arm out, and it ended up being around the neck, and that's not allowed. But it's harsh being off the field for 10 minutes when you're the captain, and it's in such a vital part of the game. You're leading by 1 point. It's a knockout competition. There's maybe 20 minutes left in the game. So let's see what happens with St. Peter's. Let's see how their spirit is, see if they can lift now and come together and play as if there's 16 men instead of 14.
Well, whether that warranted a yellow card, I don't know. Whether it even warranted a penalty, I'm not sure. But what's done is done, and St. Peter's now find themselves down to 14 men, just like they did in the league game. Aditya Veeratunga can't control the ball. And Harith Bandarad is able to. And now Isipathana trying to run again through Gayan Vikramaratne, who's tackled well by Teekshan Eshan. He's been good defensively today, Eshan. Great technique at the breakdown there from Tushan Indunil. Smashed in the tackle, but not from an onside position. And now the ball is loose. And flying through was Gayanath, but the referee will bring it back for the penalty.
So he was up pretty quick, the big man. Probably a bit faster than Usain Bolt if he was onside. Isipathana decided to take on, to play on quickly.
Ball went backwards, says the referee, which it did. And Diaz Fernando gets the first chance to run in this game. Manages to get the pass away. Beautifully done there to Ratnayake. And now straight through the gap goes Avishka Heenpalla. Heenpalla still going, gets caught by Samod Fernando. Looked like it, that was around the neck too, so the referee needs to be consistent. And now coming away with it was Samod Fernando. And now Harith Bandara puts the kick back, and Diaz Fernando, who started it all, has to juggle it. And now he's got just one man in support. Good tackle on him by the Isipathana replacement, Ahmed, who has come on. And that tackle has taken a bit of the wind out of Diaz Fernando's sails. Ahmed with a smash tackle on him. If you can see that replay, it would be nice. But the game's really opening up now, Chamli.
Yeah, Isipathana realizing that St. Peter's fullback is Sinbin. They were kicking, but I think they were kicking to the wrong direction. They were kicking straight to the person who is at the back, so they had to kick to the space. I think now Isipathana has to get some points because St. Peter's is short 14 men in the park, and Isipathana has to score.
We can see all the people in the stand standing up as well, giving a little bit of advice to the referee too. So it's tense time here at Royal Complex Ground, and everyone's involved.
Well, this is the period of the game. It's going to be won and lost. Ishan, how hard is it now for St. Peter's with Sandesh off the field?
Captain going on is a big blow for St. Peter's, especially he not being there for 10 minutes. But we saw some good individual brilliance by Avishka Impel and Diaz Fernando, who managed very well, but unfortunately was not able to secure the ball. I think those senior players need to step up and take the lead in the absence of the captain. And we saw some leadership being seen over here during the play.
So now, Shanika, it's all about game management. So St. Peter's have a man off the field, so they're just slowing things down a little bit. The referee's got to make sure that this doesn't go over time. Obviously, he's called time off, but he's got to make sure that this doesn't creep into the game more and more.
Absolutely, and that 10 minutes is on the running clock, so don't forget that the Milo President's Trophy semi-finals will continue tomorrow. The home team, Royal, will take on St. Thomas's. Little bit of controversy there also with regard to an independent or neutral venue.
Time on!
The sponsors have made sure that the games stay at the Royal Complex just to ensure some continuity. Royal will be hoping to not repeat the 79th minute and 50th second mistake against St. Thomas's tomorrow. St. Thomas's, with a few injuries, also will face an uphill task as Kushan Indunil, the Isipathana captain, pops this ball up to Sumudhuran Kotke, and his pass is not good. Samuel Fernando now manages to step through three tackles. Rankotke has had a poor game today, along with Randy Silva, which is why Isipathana have not been as fluent. Ekanayaka The little prop trundles forward as only he knows how. Ruberu, Ragisha Veerasinghe. Lovely ball. The wraparound. Offload to Adisa Veerathunga. Another brilliant offload from the floor. But St. Peter's turn it over. And now Ravin Yapa will try to come away with the ball. Manages to turn onto the correct side, Yapa.
St. Peter's need to get out of the jail, need to get out of this half and play in their half.
Dean Palla to Sivaraj, who puts a low kick in. And this goes to the danger man, Gayan Vikramaratne. Now it's a long, long ball out to Chamoth Fernando. He looks inside, finds the willing accomplice in his right wing partner. And now the numbers have opened up. Here's Ratnayake. He scored the first try. In fact, it's Sivaraj now. Looking for support. Riyad Fernando, oh dearie me. Sumudhu Rankotge gets the cross and makes a telling interception. And the pass goes forward. But, my goodness.
Riyad Fernando, I think the running angle was wrong over there. He should have gone out. And Steven Sivaraj should have just put a small kick. And Diat is, I think, probably the fastest in the ground, maybe second to Ratnayake.
Well, Ishan, you could see Diat Fernando staring daggers at Sivaraj, but I don't think it was Sivaraj's fault there.
The number 10 looked like it was the petrol tank was on E and flashing, and then Royal came. I mean, Isipathana came back and looked like they had an opportunity and. The tackle came across and Kokke just had the ball knocked forward and it went forward a couple of metres, and so the referees brought it back.
Well, it's all happening here at the Royal College Sports Complex. The Milo President's Trophy knockout final. Knockout rugby is completely different from league games, obviously. And you can see exactly why. Isipathana are comfortable winners in the league competition, but here it's a one-point lead. Everything is on tenterhooks. Everyone around the ground tense as ever. Lovely shove coming through from Isipathana. And the knock forward is forced. And is this where Vagisa Veerasinghe rallies his troops? Sandesh Chavikram is off the ground. What's going to happen next?
So how about that scrum? The leg drive from Isipathana was magnificent. And it looked like St. Peter's all had ice skates on and were just standing there and going backwards.
I think the game pace is getting into the forwards because they were running around the field because St. Peter's made a 40 meter run and then suddenly Isipathana made a 30 meter run. So the forwards suffer really bad when you have runs like that in the game. I think it showed in the scrum they could not hold it. And Isipathana forwards are doing really well winning that scrum back towards them. And I think Isipathana is trying to get points with a one man shot.
Yes, and hats off to this team on the front row because they play the full 8 minutes every game. They don't have a lot of front row replacements on the bench. Biangwila has come on for St. Peter's, but Vagisa Veerasinghe now goes off the back dummies nicely, just in time with the ankle tap was Stephen. And Veerasinghe again plays scrum half, which is where he started off life. Gayan Vikramaratne, lovely angle from. And now Padmasankar in for the corner. Diaz Fernando has to make the tackle. He does. And Kushan into the lovely offload to him. Harit Bandara almost makes it to the line. Isipathana. Line. But the referee says it was holding on. And St. Peter's just do enough to hold on to get away.
Some beautiful, beautiful offload we saw with Isipathana hands. But unfortunately, holding on to the ball.
Yes, it was some outstanding work from Kushan Idulil in particular. Managed to get the offload and the runner didn't have to break stride. Sivaraj looks pretty knackered but manages to thump that ball 40 meters.
Well, that was another example of what we've spoken about all year. And that's the attitude that Isipathana have when their players make the break. All their players work and support to get on the inside and be there for that extra pass. He just saw that the man knew as he was going to ground, he could turn around and a player would be there. One of his mates would be there to help him out.
Yes, well, I think Isipathana has to get points They have been going close to the try line, but they were missing out in points in this game. But I think now it's time they should get some points on board.
Good well line. Taken there by Guru Singha. St. Peter's have had a few options in the line out. Yapa now picks it up and goes after Del Pajitra, makes a good run as well. Good defense from Isipathana, managing to hold the big man up. Team Palla, Sivaraj. Flat ball to Deekshan Eshan. Diaz Fernando now coming into the game more and more. And oh, but he did stay inside. Yes, he did. Ratnayaka puts the ball back and Sudhu Rankot gave the recipient once again from a beat right pass. Diaz Fernando makes a crucial tackle once again in the 22. And walking the tightrope down the touchline was Ratnayaka at that particular moment. We thought he'd had enough to go all the way. And now Heenpalla thinks about the quick throw, but Kusan Indulal has shut that option down. But this is end-to-end stuff, Paul. We're gasping for breath in the commentary box.
Well, a lot of it's been created by simple mistakes and a few simple errors, but there we had an opportunity, St. Peter's had an opportunity to sneak down the line and the ball comes back in. And it's so frenetic, the pace of the game, that there's holes all over the place because it's really being played like a sevens game.
Well stolen there by Gayanath that time. Crucial moment in the game. And here's Kushan Idunil, gives it to Padmasankar. Padmasankar puts his shoulder into the tackle and he makes it through. Coming across was Ratnayaka with an excellent cover tackle. And look at the second row getting up there. Diaz Fernando does excellently to thump that ball into touch, but he was under serious pressure from Gayanath and Harit Bandara, who just gotten up there. And now the pressure is all the way back on St. Peter's. You couldn't write this script if you tried.
Well, the whole crowd is standing at the moment, and so no one knows what's going to happen next, but there's a lot of noise, and there's a lot of pressure, and there's a lot of intensity out there.
Sandesh Javikram is back just in time. His team have almost scored in the time he was off. Isipathana have almost scored in the time he was off. He must have been watching and wondering what was going on. Veeratunga with a nice take up the front. And that's a good leg drive from Isipathana. It looks like it's got the momentum to go inside. It's a try. Looks like Devin Gunaratna this time who's come up with the ball. And there was just nothing that St. Peter's could do. They looked like their tanks were completely empty. And you can't blame them for conceding that try.
I think St. Peter's opting to not contest and stay away, but I think one guy accidentally got engaged in the line-out and it was just walk-through for Isipathana forward. I think legs were working really well and they got through comfortably.
Yes, indeed. It was just a lapse in concentration from one of their players there. You can see Rahul Del Pachitra looking completely flabbergasted as to what happened. Just engaging a little too early, the Peter Wright defender.
Mother.
And that could be the score that turns the game. Gayan Vikramaratne with a crucial conversion here, because this conversion could take them to 26 points instead of 24, which means that St. Peter's have to score a goal to win it. A try won't be enough, a penalty won't be enough. And it's just wide of the right uprights. So it's still everything to play for now, St. Peter's. If they have a try in them, could still win this game. It's 24 points to 20. And we have seen everything happen here. This game has not disappointed the neutrals. And it certainly has had the heart rates pumping of both team supporters. Jai Vikrama. Vagisha Veerasinghe opts to play it safe this time. And Padmasankar on his left boot gives it to Avishka Heenpalla. Heenpalla steps inside, two tackles. Still going, the little scrum off. Well, it's not so little. In his new pink boots. And they've lost it. And now they've roughed it forward. St. score still going. Mistakes from both teams. It's become scrappy, but it's highly entertaining. Sivaraj looks for the long ball, and Sandesh Jayavikrama with the fend. Kushani Duril makes an important tackle again, but concedes the knock forward. Huge tackle by the captain on his opposite number.
TK and Hishan struggling from cramp, I suppose. Yeah, he was not there to support during the breakdown. Almost costed them.
Well, now St. Peter's for the first time are chasing the game. And Isipathana just need to get down into opposition territory, Shamli. That's all they've got to do.
Shanaka, as the start, I said this game till the final whistle, you can't say who is the winner. So I think this is a very good game. Both teams are playing some open running rugby. And I think the boys are feeling how hard that they have worked. I think the fitness levels and players intend to make mistakes when they are tired. Because that was a clean ball towards Isipathana number 10, and he just dropped it.
Nilamuddin has come on for Devin Gunaratna in the third row, bringing on some water for Isipathana. Just on the right of your screen there is Lasinta Di Costa. He's a good guy to have coming on there and just having a small word to settle the nerves. Log on to thepapare.com at 6:30 p.m. every day for the recap, your daily sports update, which brings you the day's news and information from the sporting arena every day, 6:30 p.m. on thepapare.com. And it's an important scrum for St. Peter's here. And referee says, very correctly, that Serum broke away and rejoined the scrum. Can't do that. Just mistimed his collection. And Padmasankar's chip kick rolls into touch. He won't mind that.
Yeah, it looked like there might have been a little bit more space further down. If he'd put down a long raking kick, he might have made a little bit more ground for sure. But it just shows how much pressure is on the players right now. The intensity is really high, and the pressure is right on them. And that's why there's these little mistakes, like the balls are being dropped, and throw-ins are not going quite as straight as they should do. So let's see who can hold their nerve.
Well, we've got to pick a man of the match. It may be too early to do that, depending on who wins this game. But there's a fall in the line out there. Knocked forward from Isipathana. So, gentlemen, while we're watching this play, just think of your men of the match. Ravin Yapa, still full of running, the big hooker. Heenpalla. And now Isipathana have committed numbers close to the ruck to defend. And Avishka Heenpalla now. Steven Sivaraj, lovely flat ball to Tishan Eshan. Looks for Viat Fernando, finds him. And Viat Fernando is going for the line. Fernando needed to keep that in hand. He's had a brain freeze. Oh my goodness, Viat Fernando may just have thrown this semi-final away.
It was all about that pass. The pass from the 10, Steven, and then that pass just on the outside. There's a player on the inside too, and he looked like he might have had the pace. He put it into fifth gear and then just dropped it onto the toe, and he knows that wasn't the right option. There's 2 minutes to go till time's up, but they're in the right end of the park, so and it looks like by their spirit they haven't given up, so they're going to keep going. And
St. Peter's having their game of the tournament. I think they're giving all out over here, but some basics, they need to get the basics right, which is costing them.
Mahapitikama to throw into this crucial line-out, well taken by Adisa Veeratunga in front there. And Isipathana will just try to run the clock down here. Smart play from them. And Ruberu gets a decent enough touch. So, gentlemen, we are discussing the player of the game. Looks like it's probably going to come from Isipathana. Diaz Fernando could have snatched it there if he managed to score the try, but he didn't.
Oh, look, the fat lady hasn't gotten the microphone to have a chance to sing yet, so it's a little bit early to call the man of the match. But I'll say number 8 for Isipathana. What a singer has had a fantastic game again. He's He's made lots of breaks. He's covered up lots of holes.
Paul, I think Kushan Indulian, the Isipathana captain, he was leading in front and he was doing some great defense work and some volleyball going on the field.
Yes, looks like they're practicing for the Olympics there with the volleyball. And now Biang Wheeler, the prop, has to cover it backwards. Excellent tackle on him by Chamoz Fernando. And Isipathana with the counter up. Was he off his feet? No, says the referee. And Kavisha Madhushan will play from half. And Kushan Indranil will do the smart thing. And Sumudhu Rankotge drops yet another ball. He's dropped more balls in this half than he has all season. But just shows that he is Hickman. And to agree with Shamli, Kushan Indranil, I think, stood like a rock on the park. And Vagisa Veerasinghe had an outstanding game as well. So we'll probably give it to Kushan Indranil as man of the match. But what a game it has been. Isipathana coming through in the end to win it by 24 points to 20. A stunning game of rugby. Everything that you could have on offer. They scored tries from forwards, from backs. There was broken field play, end-to-end stuff, ball, and an entertaining encounter. And the winner of this game will be the favourite for the final for sure.
Well, I've got to say, it's hats off to both teams. They really put it out there and gave everything. St. Peter's, that was a fantastic effort to push. It's about them so close, and it was what, maybe 4 metres. They were 4 metres away from winning that game. They almost scored in the corner in the last minute of the game, and they just didn't quite manage to have the petrol to go all the way. And as Isipathana showed again that they played the full 80 minutes, and they were pressing to score again in the last minute of, in the last phase of play.
Adi Saviratunga just sitting on the ground, can't even take the congratulations of the fans who have flooded the pitch so far, because he's so tired and they did him so much work. And the St. Peter's team deserves all the credit as well, Ishan. They did play and they had several chances to kill the game off, just couldn't get passes, crucial passes to hand. And I think they've got only themselves to blame for that.
As I mentioned, yes, I think they played their game of the whole tournament, but they need to get the basics right. Whereas there were so many good breaks, but unfortunately they haven't been managed to utilize them to convert to a try. And over here we can see once again Isipathana winning by just an edge, and the whistle was also blown few seconds before the game was over. So pretty much unfortunate, but I think Isipathana deserves that. They did play a very good game previously as well, and they got a good break previous. They didn't have a good game last week. Isipathana overall, they played as a team and they won overall. So wishing all the very best to Isipathana for the next finals, big finals.
Yes, the big final will be coming up next Saturday, and that will be against the winner of tomorrow's game, to be played right here on this ground. And that will be brought live to you on Dialogue TV as well as ThePapare.com. We'll join you at 4 p.m. for the live broadcast of that game between St. Thomas's and Royal. And Royal will be hoping to avoid that last second loss that they conceded to St. Thomas's, who have suffered a few injuries in the lead up to this game. Their quarterfinal game was not the best as well. So we'll have to wait and see whether things go according to a plan for St. Thomas's and Royal. And don't forget, the man of the match for this particular encounter was Kushan Indranil, the captain for Isipathana. He set up a couple of tries as well and scored one himself with an outstanding little drive through the middle from close range, and made some crucial defensive hits as well, besides leading his team to come back from 13-0 down to win it by 24 points to 20. So Kushan Indranil gets our man of the match, as we can see scenes of desperation from the Peters player. Sandesh Jayavikrama being hugged by one of his teammates. And that's the amount of breakdown for you as we look at the Pete Wright players on the ground, really dejected. They tried their hardest today and they left everything on the pitch.
That's right, Shanaka. And this is what I love about sport. If you don't emotionally invest in the game, if you don't put everything you have, there's no point. The reward at the other end doesn't mean as much. And so this is what these boys have put in. They've put in everything they have, emotionally, physically, all everything into this team. And look at them. You can see that they're spent. And you can see what it means to them.
Yes, Fernando is sobbing, man. He should. because he had a couple of chances.
Because I think rugby is the winner today, because both teams played some superb rugby, and we at the record here also, we were, our hearts were also pounding very fast at certain times. But the open game, I think some tiny mistakes cost the game. I think even Isipathana, they did a lot of mistakes in this game, but they are lucky to be the winners today.
Yes, I think it was just a case of who was able to capitalize on the opposition's mistakes, and there's nobody been better than Isipathana in doing that today. So that brings us to an end of this first semi-final, as we look at teams and camps with opposing emotions. And the Peterites absolutely dejected, but they can hold their heads up high because they played an outstanding game of rugby today. They contributed 50% of what was a superb evening's entertainment for everyone watching. So they can go back and pat themselves on the back once the emotion of this defeat leaves them. They will realize that they had an absolutely outstanding game of rugby that they were a part of. So that brings us to the end of this coverage of the first semi-final of the Milo President's Trophy. We'll be back tomorrow. And that will be for the match between St. Thomas's and Royal, the winner of that booking themselves a finals berth against Isipathana. So that's going to be a cracking game to look forward to tomorrow as well. We'll join you then from the moment with from Ishan Noor and Shamli Nawaz, Paul Toya and myself, Shanika. It's goodbye for now.
I start each day with a dream to win. Training, working hard, rain. How strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life.
කොහේ ගියත් කොතැන හිටියත් ශ්‍රී ලංකා පිළේ එංගලන්ත සංචාරයේ උණුසුම් අවස්ථා ඔබේ මොබයිල් එකෙන් සජීවීව Dialog My TV වෙතින්ම පමණයි. ඩේටා කාස්තුවක් නොමැතිව දවසටම රුපියල් 333ක් වැනි සුළු මුදලකට ඇති තරම් නරඹන්න. ස්පෝර්ට්ස් ටයිප් කර 82.82ට SMS කරන්න. Dialog within My TV අනාගතය ආදායි.
ළමයෝ දැන් ඩේටා වලට ඔච්චර ලෝභ වෙන්න ඕන නැහැ. ඔන්න ඩයලොග් හෝම් බ්‍රෝඩ්බෑන්ඩ් එකේ ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
එහෙනම් ඩබල් ගෙවන්නත් වෙයි.
නෑ, තීන ඩේටා වගේ ඩබල් ලැබෙනව පරණ ගාන්ටම නොමිලේ. ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ අංකකේ සහ වේගවත්ම ඉන්ටර්නෙට් සම්බන්ධතාවයෙන් දැන් රෑට ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
ඩේටා ඩබල්?
ඩයලොග් අනාගතය ආදායි.